Bellevue police suspect there may be a good deal of funny money floating through the metro. A teen allegedly trying to use a bogus bill at school leads investigators to a bunch of counterfeit cash. Officers arrested 22-year-old Emmanuel Mashik after they say they found equipment in his Omaha home to print money. KATV News Watch 7's Michelle Bandour live with the latest on the investigation. Michelle?
Rob, the teen caught trying to pass the phony 50 is in custody tonight. His older brother also in jail, and both face serious charges, possibly federal counts, allegedly caught with a lot of that fake cash.
If you look at some of these, they're right on.
$8,000 in bogus bills, now in evidence at the Bellevue Police Department.
Found four bags of partial bills, a box full of newly printed ones that were along with the printer, and just supplies needed to make the currency.
Police say a 16-year-old boy used a fake $50 bill to get into a basketball game here at Bryan High School on Friday. When the school counted the cash yesterday, they noticed the bad money. Then the school got suspicious when another student tried to pass another fake $50 at the school store.
The student who had him at the high school essentially stole him from his brother.
The fake money trail led Bellevue police and federal Secret Service agents to this larger stash of cash they say they found in Emmanuel Mashik's home near 120th and L in Omaha. Police seize a computer, printer, paper cutter, ink, evidence, they say, of a counterfeit cash operation.
It sounds like that, and it looks like they were trying to get very good at making the counterfeit money due to the many times they've made mistakes and did remakes and cut new ones.
For now, it appears police managed to shut down the printing before the counterfeiters could perfect the cash.
Well, investigators believe there's more fake cash out there. Omaha police have confiscated money that matches the illegal serial numbers from the ones found in Bellevue, and they say there could be even more arrests. Reporting live, Michelle Bandour, KETV, Newswatch 7.